One, I will call to order the Select Board meeting March 20, 2017. First thing I'd like to do is review minutes. We have three different types of minutes. Our regular board meeting last Monday, Mike's minutes on the election postponement meeting of Monday morning, and my minutes, excuse me, of the review of bids with Steve Pike last Monday morning. So I did mine kind of late, so if you didn't have a chance to look them over, we can keep them for next week. But do you have comments or?
I wasn't there, so.
Which one did you have there?
You're talking about when we.
No, this is when we spoke with Steve.
Yeah, okay.
That's the one. So if you haven't had a chance to look at it.
I did, and they were fine.
Okay. And Mike's on the.
On the election, yep.
Okay, so I'm good with that too. And the regular ones from last Monday?
Yep.
All right, so by consensus, I think we're good with all three of them. We will now go into community input, and Lorraine and Emily would like to come up.
Thank you.
Do you know them, Sally? Did you get them?
I have one. I'm Lorraine Hanson, Watson Lane, and this is Emily Quirk from Main Street. Approximately some months ago, we had come before the board. I asked the board to see if we could have a recommendation to have an alternate appointed to the library trustees so that we would have a full complement in case someone was out. And as it turned out, we had recommended Emily Quirk, and this board happily was able to go along with our recommendation. But at the time, and I'd forgotten this, I know that you had suggested that she only be on until March so that we could have her in sync with all other appointments, because this would have been an odd time for a year appointment. It would come up at an odd time of year, and you wouldn't remember. So we're asking that she be reappointed for a full year at this time so that she'll be in sync with everything else. We desperately need her as an alternate, because not only is Emily an alternate, she is the one who developed a campaign for the library to rediscover the library this year, so we really want her. So that's where we are.
All right, so do we want to do this now, or do you want to just accept the recommendation and do it with all of the appointments later on in the meeting that we're going to do?
If they're not.
Okay, so I'll entertain a motion.
That Emily Quirk served as for a one-year appointment?
Yes.
For one
as an alternate.
Year, as an alternate for the library trustee.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Maybe we'll see you next March.
Thank you.
She keeps going right here. Probably beg you to do that.
Thank you.
Charlie, Nancy, any community input?
I've got a quick question. I've got from reliable sources that for some reason the Rollinsford plow truck was plowing Portland Ave?
Four.
What?
Route 4.
Route 4, Portland Ave. Why?
Okay.
No, I just,
yeah.
I told them I'd bring it to the board and see what.
Thank you.
I had one other piece of business.
Sure.
If I might. I sent this letter both by email, and this is a copy that I'm also sending by mail to the board. This is after this past town meeting. I do know that in the past couple of months, I've spoken with various people who have told me that they thought that it was pretty perilous trying to get into this building during voting day sometimes. And the other problem was also the town meeting. If you get parking over at the school, if you get a lot of people, it gets kind of hard. So the people that are older have to go through the trouble. And as a result, I was going to ask if this board would consider meeting with the Legion and perhaps finding out if there's some way we could rent the space at the Legion for these big events such as voting days and for the town meeting.
Mm-hmm.
So that when we have quite a few people, we could be able to have that full complement. Because I know that a lot of elderly people come to the breakfast and they seem to have no trouble getting in there. The parking seems to get into the Legion, and it seems to work out well for them. So that's what I was wondering. Maybe we could entertain some kind of dialogue with the region and find out if that's possible.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea. I know personally, I share your concern about voting in this building. I mean, the parking and on a day in September, there's just, you have to back out, there's traffic, people are walking, trying to get in.
It's frightening.
Yes, it is to me too. So I think it's a good idea. I don't know that if you want us to check in on all of us, but I think I would like to hang on to this, and maybe as we've got a lot of work to do these next 4 or 6 weeks.
Not that you have nothing to do.
So personally, I would not want to lose sight of this. I think it's a really good idea. Of course, we'll have to invite conversation with our town clerk, our moderator as well.
I've sent the town clerk a copy of this letter.
Oh, okay.
This same letter, and hopefully she can think about it too, and maybe we can talk to the people at the Legion or something like that.
Yeah, I think the problem, just off the top of my head, it's the Saturday meeting day that we may have to, say, look, we'll be happy to pay you, because that's their prime, one of their prime function days.
I understand, but if we could do something, and even if we do have the voting, I know that in the past, they've just said that anything we want to do, they're fine with. I think if we can give them something, it'd be great, even if we have to raise some money to pay them, raise donations or something, to pay them something.
It's a good point. We'll take it under consideration, probably, unless there's a, unless the board tells me something differently, probably not for 6 weeks or so.
Oh, I understand.
So we, maybe it'd be good to get a, I don't know how we'll figure it out, but committee or whatever, but I think it's a point well made, well taken.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We may not want, I know it's kind of very busy on the next 6 weeks, but we may not want to wait that long, only because I'm sure the calendar fills up. There'll be several days that we need to reserve.
Would you like to give them a call?
The select board is the one that's charged with them.
Jody, do you have any objection to our exploring, at least finding out from the Legion?
Very good idea.
What their cost might be.
We asked it before this last one.
I just thought this is going to happen.
So let's just find out and get some,
We asked it before this last one.
All right, so I guess. Chief Rutherford.
Right, we'll do what happens if they say that was too close to the time.
So thank you. Thank you for your presence, the presence of your firefighters at the meeting. I think it made a difference.
Saw your Bailey Fosters.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
And congratulations to all of us. I think, the town did the right thing.
Well, kind of like what I said before, when it comes to something, it's really amazing how much the public really knows, other than the fact that they dial 911 and the fire truck is supposed to show up, the actual operations and what it takes to, make the organization work as it should. Just some of the questions that were asked, and some of them were very good questions, and people didn't understand, why you can't have a fire truck in a week, that kind of thing. Because actually, this right here is the bid package. This is the specs for a new fire truck right there. This is the one that would probably 90% sure what we're going to have as our manufacturer. And this is what I've got for 6 other manufacturers. So you got to read through this stuff line by line, just like we would do with our budgets, to make sure that all the specs are what we're going to expect.
This is as a result of the 3 bids that you initially put out last fall. Is that okay?
Exactly.
So what is this company that you've asked for?
This manufacturer right here. What I've done is just to kind of, I'm down here somewhat tonight just to find out, timeline, how this is all going to work.
Me too.
Yeah, okay. Because I can tell you what we're doing, but I got to make sure, it all jives with.
Yes, we have to really be well coordinated because of cash issues.
Yeah, and I totally understand that, and I kind of wanted to see where we needed to go and what speed we can go with and whatnot. But what I did is, we have, this is the bid, this is what we put in. See, what we did is we put in our specs, what we want. We gave it to the manufacturer comes back with this, and they'll put everything in it, including their price and the whole bit right here. And so, Somersworth has two, Milton has one, Rochester has one, so there's a lot of these vehicles around, it's not like it's an
from this particular manufacturer?
From this manufacturer, yeah. A few years ago, maybe about 10 years ago, Smeal is a truck manufacturer, and they started getting a foothold in the area. Dover started getting them, and Durham had some, Somersworth had one, so once a company that's new to the industry gets in and establishes a foothold, well then it kind of blossoms up, and Toyn has kind of done that. So like I said, there's already five in the area. Warwick's another community that needed fire trucks, and they're actually buying two, because we're not in that boat. They let them go so long that they had to bond. They're bonding over $1 million for two fire trucks. And I think that Toyn's gonna win their bids also, so that's two more in the area. I mean, I don't understand the reasoning behind that, why you do two at the same time, because they're always gonna be doing replacement at the same time. They always stagger these things, but hey, that's somebody else to worry about. But what I did is, I also looked over Somersworth's last agreement. They had a Toyn that they purchased from this company in 2013. And what I did is I have them specs also, because we were kind of, some of the stuff is light. I pulled out the sales agreement and made a copy of it, and I'll give each one of you, just so you can look at it, give you a little bit of background.
I'm interested in like a payment schedule is kind of...
Some of that's in there. So, I mean, this is all pouring around all of us, I guess, right?
Like, what do they need up front? That's the...
I don't know if all that's in there, but I can give you a bit of it, just so you have your own copy, peruse it, do what you need to do. But it irons out some of the actual stipulations that we have to meet. So, and the other thing we're doing is the guy that's the salesman for Toyn is actually coming in the station tonight. We're gonna sit down with him, and I'm gonna ask him some of the questions about payments, timelines, and how all that stuff is to work, so I can start gathering that information and bring it back here so we can figure out where we need to go.
So that we kind of all understand where the hurdles are.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we've jumped over the first and most important one, that is to get the authority from the town to buy the fire engine and to finance the purchase of that fire engine.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a really good thing. The grant, it appears that, you know, our program officer at DES said that the EPA was going to allow the extension of time that we needed, so that's good. But we can't, you know, we still really can't count on that money until it goes to governor and council and gets the final approval. So,
yeah.
So that's an unknown. The third unknown is whether we need a loan for the full freight, or we need a loan for the full freight minus the grant of $109,000. We still need to have approval on that loan. So, I'm finishing up the loan application. It should be in USDA's hands like soon, but I'll need to find out a couple of things. When will they be able to let us know? And also, as a backup, just because of where we are in the scheme of things, to apply to the bond bank as a backup for that loan, as well as the other two, unless we hear something reasonably soon. So for the piece that we probably need to act on the most quickly, we appear to have the least certitude. But we're trying, I'm gonna be asking Dana Stairs through Caroline to transfer, you know, the reserve fund money that just came through from the Warren articles. And so we might be able to use that as a deposit for the fire, because we know a couple of things.
Yeah.
We don't know that for sure that the grant's gonna come through, not for sure, 100%, right?
Sure.
But we know that we're gonna be able to get a loan. It's just going to depend on where and what. So if our cash can cover the initial deposit, I mean, I'm assuming they don't want it all up front, right?
They usually like at least half.
Yeah, I can tell you that I know from other purchases that it's not up front. You may give them, you know, like a down payment to get going.
So that's what would be really helpful to know, is that.
That's exactly what I want to find out from the salesman tonight. Because halfway through this, the company takes the individual, whether it be me or some of the other individuals, and they're going to take us out to Iowa, wherever they build these things, and you go through an inspection process to see how your vehicle's coming along, and bring your specs and make sure they're doing what they're supposed to do, and that's all on their dime. It's all within this package, so that we can make sure things are moving forward. But I know that it's portion in some place, and then there's the other portion when you receive your fire truck, so it's not all at once. But each manufacturer is different.
Yeah.
I will get all that information tonight on what their payments are.
Okay, so that would be helpful.
Yeah.
And I guess the next thing we would need from you is the a purchase order. I mean, as soon as we get
all that together,
figure
out what
purchase order,
we're ready to move forward. I can do it.
With the addition,
This is a sample, this isn't ours.
That's just a sample.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's just.
Was it the price that got you going? No, the year, the price, the town, I'm like, wait a minute.
No, that right there is.
I think it was just to show us what terms are.
Right, yeah, exactly how these sales agreements are gonna be, and that's what will be on the front of the package when we sign it. So I just wanted to give that to you, so you're not totally blinded by it. It's just a little background.
You can stop red lettering, red, whatever.
It's the background, yeah, you look at that, no, we got 450, why did it say 471? See, I understand all that. But it also says City of Summersworth, no, it's not gonna say that on our truck.
I'm like, wait.
I pulled that out this morning when I was, you know, doing some other stuff, and I thought it might be valuable just to, you know, start some background, so, because it's.
And one of the things is, it says with it, it'll take 300 days.
That's.
Well, 270 is what.
Yeah.
So.
That's right, because of this, right? Like I said, we could get it demonstrated, because I do drive them all around and let people look at their stuff. But I had that question asked to me by two or three different citizens at the meeting on Saturday. I says, why does it take so long? And I says, well, because each town has its own specific needs. And then we could pull one off, you know, the shelf someplace, and it may not have half of what we really need is necessary to get the job done in our community. That's why we go this route. And they understood that, but they didn't see it at first.
Well, many of us just don't have the experience of going out and buying fire trucks.
Well, I'll say I'm not all that experienced either. I've seen them come and go, and in all my years, I've probably seen, you know, half a dozen of these purchased, but I've never been the one that's kind of channeling through all the hurdles. But we'll get it done. And I have enough, you know, places I can go to get my questions answered to make sure we're on the right track. So far, so good. But I just wanted to give you that information, show you what we're up against, and like I said, salesman's down there, and I'll get some more of those questions, and I can bring them in and tell you exactly, you know, payment schedule, I'll make sure we get that. Part of the reason was I was trying to get them on a timeline, it said 270 days, and I know if we get the loan from the EERC loan, that's like the end of September.
Well, we're gonna get it, I don't know what it's gonna look like now. We've got an extension on that, so either, I don't know what that's gonna look like. I don't know whether that means it's this agreement as we originally saw it with an extension of time through like next March, and so that means fine, we don't have to, you know, we don't have to just.
But if I can, I might just, you know, if I can hold that chip and not throw it at them yet and say, we need this in this amount of time, and they can make it fit in their schedule, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna give him all the information at first. And so we have this here, we have this timeline, because we have this grant. Can you make this work in this time?
I mean, it might be a no-cost extension of time on the grant, which would mean that we have to spend the money by the end of September, but not necessarily do the other part about the story, whatever. So I don't, so that's why I don't know. But by that time, we should have clarity on a lot of other financial aspects of the work that we're trying to get done this year.
Yeah, you know, it's not like I'm trying to put the cart before the horse here, but timelines is pretty critical in a lot of areas.
It is.
Both sides of this community.
Yeah, including the grant.
But if these guys really want to sell a fire truck, then I'm going to say this is some of the things that we are under to try to get it done. So what can you guys do for us if you want to get the check? If not, there's somebody else waiting right behind. So kind of puts the ball back in my court. See what they can do for us.
Okay.
That's some of my approach. Maybe it flames out and I shouldn't went that route, but I don't think that would be the case. So.
Do you have guidance or questions or anything for Chief Rutherford?
I never bought a fire truck either. So.
Yeah.
So we're all in uncharted territory.
We are.
No. I mean, I've had a little experience with it, but yeah, you guys are the ones that have to get all the
just need to make the money work.
Financing side and all that stuff. So I'll get you as much information as I can. Okay. And like I had said before, in our view, and because of how long this takes, the sooner the better. So
we understand that too.
I'm not sure how that's gonna, but I'm not giving him that information. You know, we're still finding our way through this stuff. And he may say, you know, because if I had, in reality, I'd like to see something, you know, settled with these people by the end of the month or early next month, if that's possible.
By the end of the month, maybe March?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm not gonna drag you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I like to see it back in the garage before the snow flies. We'll see. But like I said, I got to go talk to them and see what they're able to present to us, and then I'll get it back to you, and we'll just go from there.
Sounds
Sounds good.
Again, I want to thank all of you for your support and so forth. It's just not, you know, us or the organization, it's just everybody together.
It was a concerted effort to try to bring us to a good resolution, so, and it did come to a good resolution. I might also say.
Even with Tamara's efforts, thank you too, because I've had more people talking about that video that we did too. That helped them on the information side of things.
Yeah, I think we need to make more videos.
I'm ready to make some on tax rates.
I think it's a very positive thing when you have to educate the people, that's a good way to do it.
The command vehicle. So for that, my sense is to try to push that off. Again, because we might be using that cash for that in order.
That is not a big, this is our attention. So that doesn't happen until summertime or something?
Yeah.
The only thing we're going to do is we're going to talk to Chief Duchamp, because he can procure us the latest state bids, because the ones that I have are from last fall.
Yeah.
So he's going to, you know, we'll get another set of those, but no, that's not something we're going to dive into until we have this.
Yeah. Yeah, so we're going to want to put off some of these, some of the things we can put off until we get our cash flow under some clarity.
Yeah, we have no issues with that at all, but it doesn't happen for 6 months down the road, that's fine too. That's not a critical element to consider this thing.
Well, it's easier to put in place. It doesn't require.
Yeah, it's not quite as hard to say.
Right.
Any other questions? Okay, thank you.
Just in the nick of time. We're losing him. I did, I scared him away. Do we have a printout of the appointments? Okay. No, I can bring it up. All right, I have it here. So when we're ready, we can use this worksheet, I think, to help us. But here comes Jeff. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, how are you?
I'm well, thanks. How are you? Do you have purchase orders you'd like us to process first?
Yeah. First off, I'd like to congratulate the board. You guys did an awesome job Saturday at town meeting.
Thank you, Jeff. And thank you for your help and support as well.
I have a couple purchase orders. One's from Bobcat in New Hampshire. It's a 938 for a cutting edge for the snow blower. About every two and a half years we put one on. So it's $272.17, and it's coming out of the vehicle maintenance.
Purchase order number 938, Bobcat in New Hampshire, for one cutting edge for the snow blower for $272.17.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Jody?
Aye, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I'm looking at this Bobcat of New Hampshire.
Just want to make sure we, you know,
yes,
we didn't have to talk.
Second, another one for purchase order 940 to Portland North Truck Center. Our international with the exhaust leak went up there, and it's for an exhaust leak, power steering, and air leak for $1,061.17. And that's coming out of the vehicle maintenance.
Move to accept purchase order 940 to Portland North Truck Center for exhaust work done on 2013 International for $1,061.17.
Good. What is the budget on that line?
I say it's like $9,000 or $10,000.
Okay.
There was plenty of money left in it last time I talked to Carolyn.
We just did it all 3 days.
What?
Sorry. We just.
Easy come, easy go. All right, any other questions or comments? All those in favor say aye.
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 So I spent spend two for, the two big purchases was two for that VNC top kit, the water pump and other light issues.
Well, these are the, yeah, these, we have to maintain them. Just curious to know how we were doing.
Yeah, we should have.
Because it was a tough winter.
Oh, I will say we were up around $7,500. But. And last but not least, it's purchase order 939 to Sullivan Tire. I'm looking to purchase five tires for the F-550 for $1,345.85.
Also coming out of the vehicle.
That's coming out of the vehicle.
I move purchase order number 939 to Sullivan Tire for five tires for the Ford F-550 for $1,345.85.
Second.
So can I ask why five?
Mm-hmm.
Because the insurance company bought the sixth one when it was involved in the accident.
What?
When it was involved in the
How
accident.
How many tires does it have?
Six.
Thank you.
There's four in the back and two in the
front. Okay. Yeah. Any other questions? Yeah. Ready to call it? Okay. All those in favor say aye.
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 Aye. Jeff, what about these?
That's for the hydraulic motor for the sweeper.
Are we doing that?
If the board
Do we need a new bid?
I'm not knowing.
Oh, we should.
Because it's expired.
Yeah, I'll get a new bid. I'll just take this one.
Okay.
And the snow.
We didn't get a.
We have not gotten a new bid yet, so.
Okay, I'll leave it in the folder.
Questions are done. Is it our turn?
Yes.
So, did you have a chance to read Mike Trank's?
About the low salt on General Sullivan?
Yes, I'm trying to see if I can read the letter.
Yes.
You're right.
Yes.
Do you have any comments? Do you have any concerns about that? Do you want to, you know, one thought is to have him come and speak to us? Including you?
So I guess I want to know if they want no salt or just to back it down off the salt on, in that area.
Did the letter say?
I don't remember. I'll have to read it again. My thought is they'll have to put signs up to inform the public that that area will be. The only concern I have is that area. There's a lot of overhang with the trees. So maybe this summer, we can invest some money into trimming some of the canopy up there so the sun can hit the road a little more in that area. Other than that, not really.
I'm sort of doing two things at once, which is never a good thing for me. It's a recipe for disaster, actually. So I am trying to read Mike's letter. So, you know, he's talking about a brine, you know, you can do an anti-icing brine, you know, like that stuff that like Dover puts down.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
We don't have the mechanism to do that. And I don't know why that's better.
So what it does is they make a brine solution and they lay it down before it starts snowing. What does it do? It dries. So when the snow hits it, it activates it. So what it does is it actually gets down in all the crevices of the asphalt and it keeps the snow or anything kneeling underneath so you don't get a hard pack. It's easy to keep to clean up.
But why would that be a better alternative than just plain road salt? Because it's salt.
It is salt.
So I was just curious, you know, we can ask. So the question is,
less over spray.
He has offered to come to the board either like next Monday or the Monday after. And, you know, I think it would be best to have you here so that we can
Absolutely.
Fully understand. Does that seem like Okay. I think either Monday would work for him. Does next Monday work for the board? Okay, so I'll get back in touch with him and say, I also said he could also call in if he preferred.
Yep.
Okay, so I will help.
How do you spell his name?
Trank, TRAINQUE. So
okay.
It's train,
yeah.
Q.
Yeah.
Trank. So that would be March 27th, right? And I'll say 7-ish?
Sure.
Okay. All right, great. Thank you. So if you have a chance to read it more carefully, too, and he outlines the area in that letter.
Yeah, Drayton, I'm sending you the well.
Yeah.
That's why.
Okay, excellent. All right, so what's next on the list here? Oh, cardboard only. So we got your response, but...
It didn't say what, I figured it was the...
It wasn't Paul, I said the place where Paul used to be.
Ah.
It's that person up.
So they don't have, none of their vehicles are flooded out, I went and looked, and after Carolyn phoned me. And so I would know, like, there's multiple vehicles that are through that place. So I think that, yeah, we would have a hard time keeping track.
Well, that's what, you know, and Jody suspected that as well.
But like, if there was this dealer, automotive place over here, you know, he has a fully flooded out truck, it would be very well. But I think we'd have a hard time keeping track of.
Yeah, well, there was some reluctance to begin with, and, but I really wanted to at least ask you to see what you thought.
Yeah.
And the board agreed with that, so. So now that you're saying you are just as reluctant as some board members are, it looks like we'll say no to him?
Not unless he can identify or put stickers on his truck or something to, to make it stand out, where we know. Because we do that with C&J. C&J gives us all their cards, but they're in a fully flooded out truck when they show up.
So other items, you know, the Foundry IDDE, that's the identifying the plugged up drain. So we've got Dover at least, you know, informally agreeing to help us with that. Before we do anything, and we're not ready right now, but before we do, we will want to alert folks of what we're going to do and why we're doing it so that they won't be surprised. So we just need to make sure we give ourselves enough time to get the message out there to the residents for whom.
I know one of the drains that we've been having trouble with, we'll actually have to dig the road up and smoke it that way.
What do you mean, dig the road up?
On Foundry Street, the
aren't
drain.
We digging the road up for reclaiming it? I guess I'm not sure.
We are reclaiming the road, but we'll have to dig down to get this drain that's approximately 6 to 8 feet down, which the water's pumping its way up through.
Is that something we can readily do? Is that...
They're going to have a machine right on site and they start doing all the road work.
Okay.
So it's something that...
So it's not anything we're going to incur a lot of...
No.
Okay. So it's just something we have to remember to do.
Yeah.
And that's because you know that there's one that far down?
Yeah, we actually... back when we were with Scott McGlynn, he was on running the water department, we actually thought it was a water main break.
Yep, I remember you telling us that.
And it wasn't a water main break, it was actually a pump coming from our house.
So we're assuming that. All we really know is that there's an open-ended pipe.
There's an open-ended pipe that has water coming through. Yeah, avoid that.
So when you saw it, you went down that deep then?
Yeah, I believe Cantwell Excavation at the time actually did the dig that day.
Yeah.
And
is there just one or other others?
I believe there's just one in that area that's coming out there. The rest of them, what you can see, all physically see pumping out.
Okay. All right, well just keep that in mind and we'll have to orchestrate that to make sure there's sufficient time to alert the neighborhood about that activity.
Yeah. It'll be interesting.
Is there anything else that you want to talk to us about? I have Volvo backhoe on the agenda here.
Other than the last storm, we had more electrical issues with it. The heater stopped working and the four-wheel drive unit worked when it wanted. The radio kept shutting off on it. And we actually lost the sending unit for a few days.
I think you need an exorcist to get rid of the ghost if it's doing these things to you.
Yeah, right.
I think that's...
So what happened with the fuel gauge is the way Volvo installed their sending unit is like a 16-gauge wire that goes into this unit. it had actually corroded at the plug. In order to fix it, where it broke off so close to the plug, or corroded away so close to the plug, you have to pull the whole cylinder unit out. In order to do that, you have to lift the cab off the machine, because the sending unit is under the machine. So right now, we're just going to make sure that the machine is full and check the fuel and the fuel levels, because we don't have a fuel gauge in the machine.
I can use Swedish priest.
Now that, I don't know, understand that. What am I
missing? You're right, sir.
Pardon?
I said you need to come on next to something.
Yes.
You have Swedish priest.
Swedish priest to do?
The Volvo.
Thank you. Sorry. Sorry, Mike.
I did make a phone call to a couple of the dealers to have them come look at it, like we discussed. And I had two people come look at it, and then weigh up some numbers to see.
All right, well, keep us posted.
Absolutely.
Good luck. And thank you for you and your crew.
Yes.
For their efforts in the last storm and in trying to keep our equipment functioning. And
yeah, we're in good shape there, isn't it? So.
Okay.
Hopefully you get no more snow.
Same here.
Hope so. Knock on wood. Does the board have anything else on the
floor? No. Charlie?
Portland Ave.
Route 4.
Route 4.
Were we plowing Portland Ave? Okay, thank you.
Okay.
I put my gear down probably 100 feet before the road.
Okay.
When I'm turning onto Ross Road, I drop all my gear, so when the state comes by, they're not.
That's probably what it is. Okay.
Just someone asked.
Somebody asked.
No.
Siri.
No, on all our roads, like me, where I plow off a lot of state roads, you know, if it's off of Rollins Road, one of my roads, I'll drop my gear probably.
You're going to stop before you get there.
Yeah, and I saw all my gears down, so I'm making a corner. Same thing on Route 4, I'll drop my gear, you know, probably just after old Route 4. I'll start putting my gear down, so all my gear's down for when I make the corner.
That makes sense. Thank you.
So,
thank you.
Thank you.
Have a nice evening, Jeff.
You're welcome.
All right, for town administration appointments. All right, so this is when we get to set up all of these setup activities for the year. Caroline has given us the list of appointments, and I've got the spreadsheet in front of me, so we can talk about whether we're ready to make appointments. We can talk about if we're not, how to get the appointments made. I'm just going to start the way that I see them on the list. Is that okay with you?
What's your first one?
Planning board.
The first appointment we have is.
I'm not doing employees right now.
Yeah,
do you want?
Okay.
I was doing one. Boards and okay. Commissions.
Planning board.
Yes. So for planning board, we have Pat Macklin's term ending at March. His term has just ended. Kevin Haynes' term has just ended. And then we have two alternates who only have 1 year appointments. So those alternates are Glenn Chase and Patrick Alley. I think they both requested reappointment. And I know that Glenn doesn't come to very many meetings, so no. So that's what I know. So, okay.
So
you are our
at the last rep. Planning board before the chairman was fixed in the email, and we didn't, I apologize. The last planning board meeting, the recommendation was that Patrick Alley would move up to take Mr. Macklin's spot on the planning board, and that we would need to find another alternate. Mr. Chase would like to stay on as an alternate. Mr. Haynes would like to stay on as a full member.
Oh, okay.
That's agreeable to the select board.
Okay, so let me just write that down, then we can consider it. So Patrick Alley will take Pat Macklin's place. Mm-hmm. Kevin Haynes would stay on.
Mm-hmm.
Glenn Chase would remain an alternate, and then we would need to find an alternate. Then.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So.
And when would Patrick's term end?
I believe these are 3 year terms. Are they not? That's a good question. I believe they're 3 years. Yes.
2020.
Yeah. So this would be to 2020. So Patrick Alley 2020, Kevin Haynes 2020, Glen Chase, 2017. And then we still need an alternate.
2018.
Sorry, we are in 2017, aren't we?
Yeah.
Okay.
So John Hinsman stays in.
He's still on.
2019, Miles is 2019. And we still need an alternate.
So, are we ready to move the, do you want to do all of the boards at once, or do you, I just assume, like, just quickly, we come to agreement, yeah, board by board. So I'll entertain a motion for Patrick Alley and Kevin Haynes as three-year term appointments, and Glen Chase as a one-year alternate.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right. Zoning Board is my next one. We have, I think I was a little confused. Here's what I have. I have the Dennis Moore's appointment ended at March town meeting. Ron Shabbat's appointment ended at town meeting. Gary Fieldson I have as an alternate,
mm-hmm.
and Paul Casal as an alternate.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we got a recommendation from Joe. One of the meetings where I was. Do you know what that was?
Yes.
Okay.
He had recommended reappointing Mr. Shabbat,
okay.
Cazal, and Mr. Fieldson. There was concern that he had not heard back from Mr. Moore, and I haven't heard since. But I do know that the planning board is, by statute, is allowed to have a member of their board on the zoning board of adjustment, which makes a lot of sense to me. Mr. Hinsman has shown interest and offered to fill that slot if we'd like him to do it. So I'm just as happy to replace Mr. Moore with Mr. Hinsman.
So, okay, so can I ask, Paul Casalt, I think, is now a full member, isn't he? He's not.
I don't, he wasn't. The cases that were heard this past year, Joe appointed him as a full voting member for the evening. He was still listed then
as an alternate?
An alternate. So.
Okay. So now we have our 2 3-year terms that we're trying to fill.
We can pull up the minutes from that evening when you weren't here. They're reflecting that, as I recall. I don't remember the date, though, so.
Well, it was a meeting where I was not
You're finishing up the grants, so, or the applications, rather.
Okay.
Think, so.
This is either 3-6 or.
Yeah.
Okay.
I almost think it was 3-6.
The beginning of the month, so.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure I'm not adding a false one there.
Did he do it at the beginning of the meeting? That says I was there.
That's
so that's on the right one.
3-6.
He's the one before then.
So I was working on those applications the end of January.
Mm-hmm.
No.
February. It
wasn't
that long.
It wasn't.
All right, so maybe the one after, is that? After 3-6, I don't. I don't have any minutes
mm-hmm.
after 3-6.
That was last Monday, the 13th.
No, it was the end of January, the end of February.
Isn't that what I looked at?
No,
you
looked at
3-6. Just look to see who was present.
Yeah.
And then if you're not here.
Yeah, I see one right here, February 20th.
Yeah.
Aaron King.
Yes.
Joe, okay. All right, so the current board is Howard Hammond, Harold Faust, Ron Shabbat, and Dennis Moore, and Joe Coet.
Right.
So there are the five.
Right.
Paul Casalt and Gary Fieldson are alternates.
Mm-hmm.
There will be two appointments this year. Joe recommends reappointing Ron Shabbat and Dennis Moore, who may not be available, in which case Paul Casalt will be recommended. That was what the minutes report.
I would prefer to keep Mr. Kazelt on as an alternate and put Mr. Ingram on.
So again, the justification or the rationale is that by statute, we are allowed to have a planning board member on the zoning board, and this provides a good bridge.
Mm-hmm.
And did John Krebs, didn't it come up in our conversation with John? Were you there? Didn't John say that that was a good approach for us to take and to have someone there?
Yes.
Do you have any thoughts on that, Jody, or any concerns one way or the other?
No, I just don't know John personally, so I don't either.
Attorney, local attorney.
Yeah, who lives on Stockdale.
Is he the one that spoke when they were putting in the development on Clement?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
He's concerned about traffic studies.
Yes.
All right, so unless there's some concern that I'm not picking up, I will let me get my list here, I'm sorry.
All right, so I would move that we nominate Ronald Shabbat for full membership, John Hinsman for full membership, Paul Kazelt as an alternate, and Gary Fieldson as an alternate.
All right. So, and the two full appointments of John Hinsman and Ron Shabbat would be for 2020.
Right.
The alternates would be 2018. Okay, so you have a motion for Hinsman and Shabbat for 2020 as full members, and Fieldson and Kazelt to 2018 as alternates. Do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay. So moved. So whatever. The next one is the Highway Safety Committee. Chief Ducharme requested a reappointment of all current members. They are Chief Ducharme ex officio, Jeff St. Jean, we think ex officio, Kevin Hurt ex officio. So that leaves Howard Hammond, Mike Gillis, and Bill Irving.
I move reappointment of Howard Hammond, Mike Gillis, and Bill Irving to the Highway Safety Committee with a term ending in this 1 year appointment.
They appear to be 1 year appointments. I'm not sure why. So it's a 2018. Do I have a second?
Okay.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Conservation Commission. I don't know. Do we hear from Al?
Oh.
Pardon?
I don't recall saying anything.
So we have three firms that are up. Al Dion, Robin Aiken, and Jan Markey.
I would say I'm pretty confident that Robin and Al probably want to stay on. Mr. Markey been attending? There was a time when he hadn't been.
I don't know. Maybe we should touch base with Al and see if he can get to us with some ideas. Unless you have anybody else another idea, but I would like to at least touch base with him.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay. All right, Historic Committee. I believe we did hear from the current chair, Chris. Do you have the list?
The same people that are on it.
These would also be one-year appointments. So now we're in the advisory committees that are really just one-year appointments. So Chris. Yes. You want me to pull it out? Just in case they've changed since then. Because somebody would decide.
I didn't
email
today.
Did you?
Right?
Yes, you did.
Today,
yeah.
Mike Rolo, your ex officios will do that later. Celia Leopold, Patrick Alley, Kristen Palego, Ed Charpentier, and Chris. Okay, so I would entertain a motion to appoint to 1 year terms to the Historical Committee, Chris Benedetto, Celia Leopold, Patrick Alley, Kristen Palego, and Ed Charpentier. So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 All right, Library Trustee, we've done that.
I have that in my
You may not, we may need to add it, right?
I don't think they're in here at all, are they?
Library trustees?
They're in here for the better.
That's not in.
Right at the top.
Trustees of the library, I paid for it. Okay, yeah, so should be listed as an alternate?
The alternate is not listed.
Emily Corp.
Emily Corp, Q U I R K. And the recreation committee, these will be one-year appointments. I have a list, can I read them and you can see if I've got the right list?
Yes, this is.
So this is it then? Dean Meathock, Kelly Anderson, Kathy Roselli, Celia Lee, Paula Dan Colley, Roxanne Cara, Lester Wall, Blythe Hammond. We'll do our follow-ups later. So what about these people?
Yeah, so we're, Liberty is no longer an alternate.
So are these, so.
Denise is still going to stay an alternate, Janice is still going to stay an alternate.
Kelly Anderson?
Yeah, and Kelly's going to be an alternate, but Liberty hasn't determined anything.
Okay, so what, is this person a committee member or an alternate?
She is the representative from the basketball, remember we wanted somebody from a subcommittee to represent everybody? So somebody from the ice rink will be a representative, somebody from basketball will be a representative. So whenever we talk back and forth to basketball, we're going to be talking to.
But not necessarily part of the.
She's not a committee, she doesn't go to the committee meetings.
All right, okay, all right.
She has her own subcommittee of basketball.
So it's this group right here through Blythe Damon, Hammond, and then the alternates?
Yep, and this year we'll have three co-chairs because they nominated.
That's their, the committee gets to do that?
Yep, so they'll deal with that.
All right, so I will entertain a motion to appoint to the recreation committee to one-year terms the following. Dean Meathock, Kelly Anderson, Kathy Roselli, Celia Leopold, Dan Colley, Roxanne Carr, Lester Wall, and Blythe Hammond. And then to one-year alternate positions, Denise Knowles, Shayna Gervais, and Kelly Haynes. Do I have a motion for that?
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
And second. All those in favor say aye.
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 Okay, so then we're removing Roselli. Is that the one?
Kathy Roselli, she knew she could be new.
She, no, Kathy's not new. They appointed her.
Parks and Rec.
We were at the meeting.
Co-chair, and this is it?
She's.
Parks and Rec. She was part of that list they just read.
She was part of that list anyway, and then they'll work it out.
All right. Oh, look, the historical committee was here with all those people. All right, but anyway, we've taken care of it. So there are other committees that are here that we need to make appointments to? Yeah, there are actually. But they're not all here. So, stormwater. I will, rather than wasting our time, I will generate the list for the names for these folks and bring them back next week.
We want one for the last one, we need another.
Yes, why don't we do that? So, we'll round up. They weren't part on this list, so.
Suzanne, you're going to share that with me.
Oh, I will when I get it so that it's presentable, yes. Next week, we'll do stormwater, joint loss, et cetera. Yeah, it seems to be inactive at the moment. All right, so employees. Do we appoint all of our employees?
We appoint the police chief, tax collector, the highway, the road agent, emergency manager, director, and health officer. I've got it there if you're ready.
Right. Why the health officer? Because that's a state appointment.
We send a recommendation, I thought, to HHS.
We do. So we don't appoint them, they appoint.
Probably.
Yes, for sure. Yeah. All right, so if you want to read those, we can use that as a motion.
I know, Bob, you want to be appointed again?
Appoint Robert Dutron as our police chief, Andrea Cass as our tax collector, Jeffrey St. Jean as our road agent, Robert Ducharme as our emergency management director, and I guess we won't be recommended. Do we want to make a recommendation to the state to keep Sean Glidden the telephone?
No, he's there until
he resigns?
Yeah. Okay. So moved.
So moved. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
twice, I guess, again and again. Would you like to, we'll take a breather from our appointments.
What was that last thing you got appointed to?
Emergency Management Director. On behalf of the board, I'd like to thank you and your, and Officer Stevens for your duty on Saturday. Thank you so much, and thank you for your explanations to the town. I think it was helpful.
The first item, I received the cost estimate from Drew Excavating for the floor work downstairs, $2,450. And that's going to repair the electrical room, the tie-in over to the electrical panel, and then the section where the volunteers sit in the front there, where the floor is actually humped up.
Mm-hmm. Can I see this? PO. Oh, it got put away because we didn't want to have a spare PO hanging around.
I'm not sure that all three board members were privy, but Norm Drew actually took the door for the electrical panel, took the door off the hinges, cut the bottom of the door so it now swings freely. So now the generator folks are very happy to be able to get access to that panel when they do their maintenance.
Not so. This brings up a point. I mean, normally we like to get three quotes. This is a case where Norm has already devoted some time and effort to this project on our behalf at no cost. And so I certainly would have no hesitation in accepting this proposal. Okay, so what we can do, we don't have a purchase order, so what we can do if the board is agreeable is I'll sign it and ask Caroline to, we'll sign it as the proposal and ask Caroline. Can you go get one? Thank you.
Can you get a couple? Just
yeah.
A minute.
I don't know what those are. Key, do you have? Okay.
Were you writing the motion?
Yes, please.
Okay. Move to accept purchase order 1161 to Norco Excavating for work done in the basement of police department for a total amount of $2,450.
Second. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So it passes. Let me just finish this up, please. Patience, everybody. We're good.
Okay. The next two purchase orders are related to the new hire
The first one's purchase order number 1150 for the psychological exam. That's made up to the cognitive and behavioral therapies, and that's $400, and that will come out of line item number 716, preventative health.
Purchase order number 1150 to cognitive and behavioral therapies for one psychological exam for $400.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. We put the warrant, it comes out of the warrant. So I don't know what article, but warrant. Is the warrant article on this, on the drain?
Article 10.
Thank you. All right.
The next purchase order is number 1149 to Seacoast Ready Gear. So the new officer can get a physical exam and a drug screen, and the total for that is $128. And again, that will come out of the preventative health line item.
Move to accept purchase order 1149 to Seacoast Ready Gear for a physical exam and drug screening for a total of $128.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Purchase order number 1132 to Jurek Brothers, it's for ammo. Two cases of rifle ammunition for $729.04. One case of 12-gauge slug for $134.94. One case of 12-gauge buckshot for $121.21. One case of birdshot for $77.38. And three cases of 40 Smith & Wesson Wind Clean for $403.74, for a total of $1,466.31. And that will come out of the line item number 711, the ammo account.
Are you going bird hunting? Are you going bird hunting?
Pardon?
Are you going bird hunting?
No, as part of the shotgun instructor class, the officer has to learn how to shoot slug, bird shot, and...
Something else that's in there, yeah.
Apparently there's a difference.
Yep.
Move purchase order number 1132 to Jurek Brothers for assorted ammunition for $1,466.31.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
That's actually the state bid price.
Pardon?
That's the state bid price.
Chief, this is in my folder for the circulator pumps.
I asked Caroline to put it in there so we could discuss.
Sure.
Yeah. So we can, is that map correct? Yeah, sure, it is correct, okay. So if we can, we can discuss that right now. So this is the purchase order. We'd asked for a couple of bids and we never got a third. This is the lowest bid for, to replace two circulator pumps in the basement. So if you look at the quote has it per pump. I thought I remembered 7,000, that's why I was just, but it's pretty much what it is right here. Oh, it's not completed. Got it?
Two, so.
Yeah.
I move purchase order number 1160 to LaBrie and Sons. Two circulator pumps for the heating system for the police department for the town hall.
Town hall.
$6,904.
Second.
Any discussion?
PJ LaBrie.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Yes. I say aye as well, yeah. I'll just put some sort of...
Okay, my last purchase order number 1148, to a company called Qualification Targets. It's a case of targets for us. That will come out of the new combined ammo target account for $249.
To accept purchase order 1148 to Qualification Targets. The 1FCFB21M targets for $249.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And the last item that I have here, I got a number of forms that the chair needs to sign that I need to send to the police academy for the new hire.
Okay, so this is to the New Hampshire Police Standards and Training Council, and it's a confirmation of notification of New Hampshire State Law, blah, blah, blah. Are you good with my signing?
Yes.
This is application for enrollment, so it's made out in Sean DeFrancesco's name, and it's just says that we, I guess, are okay with this. I'm going to sign this one as well. Also to the Standards and Training, Police Standards and Training Council, Employee Status Notification Form A. You're saying that he meets the minimum standards from Form as a Police Corrections Officer. Okay with my signing this? Is an affidavit of background investigation. It says what we've been checking and that we've checked and we've investigated his background. Okay with my?
Yes.
Getting this one. Okay. Try to do this as quickly as possible. Ed used to drive me crazy. So I really do my best to try to speed this up.
Well, this one you're going to get at, we signed it.
I'm now doing, yes, okay. Yeah. I just want to make sure I don't want to overstep.
We've come this far, I have the captain, so I'm going to send the academy.
You don't anticipate any problems getting into the academy?
We'll know in a couple weeks.
Okay.
Right. Where he is on the list. Anything for me?
Well, we have received a grievance. And tonight, at least later on, we're going to look at our calendar. So we're looking for a Thursday. We've been requested to look for a Thursday in April. I suspect that you want to be part of this. So maybe we should try to find a Thursday in April. The time is not suggested, so I'll just say 6:30 seems to be the time that kind of works. Did you receive a copy of it?
I have not yet.
Okay, ask Caroline. So here's the 6th. There's the 13th, the 20th, the 27th.
The 27th, I'm going to be out of town.
That's a good vacation.
Okay, 13th or 20th?
13th is open so far.
Both open so far.
All right, so I'll offer up the 13th and 20th and get back to all of us. Bob, do they work for you too?
Yes.
Okay. And it is going to be public. They requested that it be a public grievance.
Well, my question is, I'm going to ask that you go to executive session.
Right now?
Unless there's some other business for the police, other than this.
No, sure. So can I have a motion?
Move that we go to non-public session for purposes of personnel.
Second.
Roll call, Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Dan, yes. Anybody back on here? Good business?
That was probably a good shot.
Yeah.
Thank you, Bob.
Okay, 4 points. All right, so, okay, yeah, the book would be a good thing to do. Not the, no, our point, our ex officio appointments to where it's
first. So we have here, is the budget committee.
Well, I would be more than happy to serve on the budget.
Yours.
It's all yours.
All right, so we'll take them all and then we'll do a motion at the end, okay?
An ex officio.
Yeah, okay. Planning board? I'm happy with that. Mike? Recreation?
Please.
Okay. Joint loss?
Please.
Historical?
Happy to serve.
Mike? Stormwater, happy to serve on that one.
We're happy for you to serve.
Landbury.
Yep, thank you. Landbury Regional Cooperative, Jody?
Yes.
Okay. Anything else?
SRCP.
I'm a commissioner for.
The 2 years?
Whatever it's not. I don't know, but I'm not up.
Okay, perfect.
All I know is I'm not up.
Perfect.
Anything else if you're looking at the book, but there's ACOG and there's energy. Neither one of them are active right now, so we can sort of wait and see if they become active. And then were there any other committees? Can you look at where the annual reports are to see if there's anything else? You know, the index? See if there's something that we missed.
Conservation, cemetery, library, fire, police. ACOG, energy, highway, joint loss, historical, salary review, stormwater.
Okay, so salary review, we pretty much decided last summer that we didn't need one anymore.
Just banned that.
Yep, and the one you said that we don't have anybody, highway safety? I don't know. I've never had one. So let me tell you what I have. I have as ex officio board appointments to some of our advisory and in some cases, statutory committees. Budget committee, Suzanne Heward. Planning board, Michael Robo. Recreation, Jody LeBoyd Carnes. Joint loss management committee, Jody LeBoyd Carnes. Historical committee, Michael Robo. Stormwater committee, Suzanne Heward. Lamprey Regional Waste Cooperative, is that it? Jody LeBoyd Carnes. Can someone have a motion to appoint?
So moved.
Okay, second. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Would you like that list, Salma, as
yes,
well?
Yes, I would. I want to ask you why you don't have conservation on there.
It's a statutorily comprised committee, so I don't believe the board serves as ex officio on that. That's the best that I can do.
It's just thought you have historical.
Well, that's an advisory committee to us. Whereas the, you know, the commission is RSA, blah, blah, blah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I think we've got committees, we've got some blanks we'll fill in the weeks ahead. Employees, board appointments. I'd like us to consider John Krebs. I've asked him, I think I sent you an email, I've asked him to send us a consulting agreement rather than us trying to figure this out. So I didn't hear from him, but I would like to have a motion to appoint him as our planning board consultant at $55 an hour approximately 10 hours a month per our budget. I have a second, first and a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And then we'll revisit when we get the actual consulting agreement on it.
Boilerplate one of these.
Yes, that's what I asked him to do, yeah. He's got that. All right, so staff, Caroline is going to be putting together the 2% across the board, so we'll be able to review that. She doesn't have it tonight, so we don't have to do anything tonight. My other question about the budget is, I'm going to, you know, the detailed budget that we work with, the one that you refer to in the book all the time, is, you know, there were a lot of differences this year between what our original and that one. So I'm going to make an official copy. Do you, is it sufficient for you, for me to send you the link to it? Do you want me to print copies for you, paper copies? What would you like?
I would like a link so I can
a link
keep
to
the map going as the time goes on.
Okay.
Instead of writing it, just makes it easier for me to write it in the book.
Okay. So links.
And if we do have to shift things around this year, it got really confusing, so I'm hoping that doesn't happen. I can't say it won't, but...
Well, I can understand...
So can we keep like a column of what it originally was?
That's what
and
I...
And what we shifted it to?
That's what I did. That's what I did last year. Well, it's possible that you weren't using that. It's possible that you continue to use the book, maybe. For the budget committee, I had, well, in my old life, what I would call the original budget, so
right.
Our authorized budget and then the revised budget.
Right.
So, because what we want to remember next budget period is we're starting with the original budget. But we had so many.
Yeah.
So, yes, we adopted that partway through, so I'll continue to do that.
Yes.
If it becomes necessary, because it's helpful, because you need to know that you can cover these additional expenses in this line. So, okay, I will do that. All right, bid reviews. So we've taken care of the circulating pump, the exterior, and the RPD flooring, not the exterior drain. So we reviewed the bids with Steve. We had the lowest bid was, I think we looked at it quite favorably in our workshop. A local contractor. I don't have the purchase order, but what do you have there?
Okay.
So, but just so that we can, we need the contract though. I think we'll hold off. We're actually going to, this is a request for bids, so Caroline's going to turn this into a contract, like we do for Bear Road, for roads. So we're going to do some kind of contract. What I would like is an official board pronouncement that we will be accepting their contract once we finish the paperwork. We're accepting their proposal, and we'll be working on the contract. The proposal was dated March 7th.
We accept the proposal, the request for a bid from Gagnon Excavation of 37.
For $38,228.
$38,228 and with a 9 cents.
No sense. And that was in reference to bid number 17-001. All right, so got a motion from Michael to accept this proposal. Let's vote.
Second.
Okay, I have a second. All those in favor say aye.
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 All right, so we'll ask Caroline now to turn this into a contract for us. All right, that's the circulating pump, exterior drain, RPD flooring, foundry and pinch hill. I've asked, can we table this for a minute, for a week or so? Okay, because we don't actually have anything in front of us. All right, we've had a right to know request from a person named
Susan Olson
from Merrimack, New Hampshire, who wants all of our correspondence with the Municipal Association, the Secretary of State's office, and the Department of Revenue Administration regarding the postponement of elections. So she asked that of us, the town clerk, the moderator, and any other official was involved in the decision. But that's pretty much it. I think Bob was as well. So we are in the process of collecting and compiling those things. So I would suggest, Board, that Charlie has made PDF documents of his, so if you have stuff, if you could make it a PDF and, you know, either forward it to Caroline or to me, and we'll just put them all together and...
Well, our emails that are approved, those are already there.
I didn't independently send anything to any of those groups except afterwards, so I've got one email that said thank you to the municipal association. So, did you initiate an email? So if you, I would say if either of you initiated an email, I mean, they were all flying around, but it would be helpful.
Like when we called the meeting?
No, it was correspondence to, specifically, from any town official to the Department of Revenue Administration, Secretary of State's office, and or the Municipal Association. That's what the request is, for our communication to those agencies, not for our...
Yes, I am not.
Okay. And our minutes of any meeting where we decided. So Michael submitted the minutes tonight, we've approved them, so they'll be part of the record. I think Charlie is the one who probably was checking in and just letting us know.
Right.
So he's compiling.
Okay.
This. Okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Sounds great.
Okay. Comcast franchise renewal. Would you mind if we just table this? Okay. We've talked about the dates to hear grievance. We'll see if we get those agreed to by all parties. Jody, you're on. What do we need to do for the rec committee tonight?
In the rec committee, we would like to offer an assistant director position to Brittany Power.
I think you sent it though, don't you?
I thought Dee sent it to you.
You could have given me a troll.
I brought in the...
Okay, let's see. Dee did send us something as well as, I don't know if it was the... It's not the... Kelly and Jody interviewed Brittany last week. I agree with the assessment on her background and skills. Brittany's familiar with RGS as a substitute teacher and the children that she's worked with. We feel her presence will be beneficial to all parties. Additionally, we would like to offer Brittany $10.75 per hour for a full-time position, meaning how many hours a week is that?
42.
So.
She's going to be graduating this year. She has, she's not going to be leaving till we get to also. And she was actually one of the people that was there at the town meeting on Saturday.
Well, that's nice. That's very cool. So let's talk a little bit, before we actually deal with this particular request, about who is it that can hire, and, you know, how much do we need to get involved is kind of the point that I'm kind of driving at. I think it's true that committees cannot hire, so the recreation committees cannot make an offer. Would you agree with that? If we had a director, would we think that director could make the offers and then present them to us? Okay. So.
Well, until we get those in place,
they have to
make a recommendation to us.
Yes. Yes.
All the way around, it eventually comes to us. We have to anyway. We have to hire them anyway.
We do. But
yes, when it comes to.
But as far as meeting, I guess what I'm trying to say is, I don't feel the need to meet with them. I know Bob brings, but I think I would be okay with a hiring process where either you have been part of it and make that recommendation to us, or the director.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and you know, you can wait till she has two or three names. I mean, you know, mm-hmm. Does that pretty much capture how we think that?
Certainly more than what we. Past,
yeah, for sure. We haven't considered
we didn't know who we hired last year.
Not at all.
Correct. All right. So is that sufficient guidance to bring back to the committee on that respect?
In the meantime,
Yes.
We do want to hire.
Yes, let's have, we have a motion with regard to Brittany.
Yeah, we can make a motion.
Brittany?
I didn't see her resume, but it wasn't attached to the guy like that. She, I don't forget, she's a student, you said?
She's graduating pre-med.
From?
She's a double major in art and early education and dance from Keene. So she's gonna have a double major, and she is substitute teaching right now, as well as she was a staff member last year. And she was, yes. And she only did field trips because she was so upset about what was going on. And when we showed her all the changes that we made, she loved it, and she wanted to add to it. And she, the structure that is gonna happen, the field trips that are structured out, the time, the, even a spot that we have for sunscreen and snack, she was happy with. So she was very happy with all the changes, and she had some changes of her own that were great ideas.
Excellent. Would you like to see the, okay. So are we ready to entertain a motion? Either of you? Jody, would you like to?
Oh, sure. I'd like to make a motion to offer a position for assistant summer rec direct, assistant director to Brittany Powers. Is there salary in that?
Yeah.
Okay. With an offering salary of $10.75 per hour for a full-time position for the summer season of 2017.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 Yay, we have our first employee. So again, going forward, if like there's a director who stays on for next year, I mean, yeah, she can just sort of agree, or he can start the process and
mm-hmm.
just bring us the, you know, the list of recommendations at some point with, you know, the resumes, et cetera, blah, blah, blah.
Exactly.
All right, I responded to Dee, I copied all of us. So with regard to some of these technicalities about the, you know, payroll, hiring, those forms, Caroline will manage them on our behalf, which is what I told her. And I said, if there's, Caroline will know enough if there's something unusual or whatever to bring something to us. That's how I handled that.
Mm-hmm.
I think we still need to figure out some of the cash management things. And I know Caroline has some ideas. So at some point, we'll get Caroline and some of the group
mm-hmm.
together here and kind of go through
yep.
some of that.
Counting money and
yeah.
collecting money.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Because we had a material finding on this, oh, by the way, in our audit. So, and while we got some very specific recommendations, I do want to take those seriously. But I'm more just to make sure we deal with adhere to the spirit of it. You know, not necessarily mm-hmm. each individual one. Just the, you know, what he's trying to say is you need more control.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, which we kind of knew. All right, was there anything else, Jody, with regard?
We're meeting again on Sunday.
But nothing that we have to attend to tonight?
No, we submitted the work.
Work
study paperwork to UNH. I have not heard back yet. But if we asked for anywhere from 2 to 6 counselors, and if they come through, because we thought we could have used them in the director position, but they need to have a supervisor. So we put them in the counselor position. So, and if we can hire them with the school paying some of that, that's going to offset our costs tremendously. So
that's great. That's excellent.
So
that would be wonderful. We'll hold a good thought for that. All right. So if there's nothing else with the REC committee, I will go on.
What's the do we have flyers or anything you're putting up, Jody, to for. So
there is everything.
The New Hampshire Hall that the
at UNH?
Yeah, that well, the outdoor rec
that is used by is one of the buildings used by them.
I'm trying to think what the department is.
This kinesiology.
Kinesiology, thank you. We should put it up on the bulletin boards in that building, I would think. And those are the people that
to hire.
Those are the ones that are doing the outdoor rec
to help us get
what is it called though.
You actually have an electronic job board now. And post your job. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you, but they don't really use those. There aren't really those bulletin boards there anymore. So
we're old.
Whomever would like like to post it? You just go online and Google like UNH job posting kind of thing? You can register and put it up.
Kristen sent a link and like somebody, one of the other girls.
In the world that I came from, we were already making great strides at becoming paperless. I'll say no more.
We should take advantage of the electronic bulletin boards at our university.
Absolutely. Anything else with the rec committee? Okay. So really nothing on credit cards. Nobody's come back to talk to us about that, so we'll just let that be. The whole highway shed, I have the bids that are due next Monday. Is that, do I have that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, excellent. Thank you for managing that. Non-lapsing account for historical committees, that's still a placeholder, Michael?
You said we would deal with it after town meeting. Is it after town meeting?
Fair enough. I don't have anything on policies and procedures either. All right, well, I can't believe it, but looks like we're at board member activities and updates. Thank you, Joe. Feel free to jump in anytime. I don't have any town things. I'll be working. I don't have any meetings. I'll tell you what I'll be working on. I'm going to complete the fire engine loan proposal and get in touch with the bond bank and start the process for our fail-safe, you know, our not fail-safe, but our backup. So that's what I'll be doing and getting the budget back to, you know, finalizing what it looks like.
I have a rec meeting Sunday night and Monday morning. I have a joint loss meeting.
Okay.
And Monday night I'll be meeting.
So do we not have to appoint joint loss? We probably should, shouldn't we?
They're not appointed, they're volunteers. So we ask them to
come. I see, yes. And we need four management, four, three, or
at
something.
At the rate we're going, we'll take everybody.
Okay.
So, and we also have to rotate chair this year. So I was chair this year, so now it has to be an employee to be a chair.
Okay, did you come to us though? Did you just say we thought it would be okay for you to stay as chair?
Yes, and we went to the state, and the state said, at first the state said, no, you have to change it every time we meet, quarterly. And I said, that's impossible. Please double check. And then he called back and says, no, you're right. I'm like, you can't change a chair every 4 months.
Who does the minutes?
I do.
And there is a, can you still do them, even though you're not chair?
Absolutely.
All right, thank you. Because that sometimes is the big, you know.
Yeah, okay. I try to write them as soon as I get home at night, or else I forget. But they've been in the computer and there.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So Jody has joint loss and rec and
planning board next week, but nothing.
Okay.
Oh, the historical committee meetings next.
Okay. So we'll we said planning board and stuff. So we'll have Caroline send out, I guess, at least email acknowledgments to various committees. Does that seem like a good thing to do? And hopefully we can get Krebs on board so that he can start.
We've already had an application in for a conditional use permit.
Okay.
For a accessory dwelling unit on Icarus or whatever. So
okay.
John is hoping to manage it. So
he is.
In the absence of a new chair. The next meeting of the planning board will be an organizational meeting, the first part to elect a chair.
Yeah. And that is first Tuesday of April.
Yes.
So the you saw I sent an email to Tom Clark. Clark had suggested a while back that we consider forming a technical, review team to look at some of these applications before they hit the planning board.
Mm-hmm.
And John Krebs has agreed to serve on one of these. But I've asked Tom to come talk to us, tell us what do these committees do, who's good to serve on them, and then we can see if we want to.
I mean, part of it is really for our own safety. I mean, apparently the past practice of every planning board chairman, but at least the one, this most immediate last one, was to meet with applicants ahead of time to flush out issues that may arise, and well, that should protect, it shouldn't be meeting.
The
technical review committee really should be flushing out questions, that sort of thing.
So, but it'll be good for Tom to talk to us about that. And, you know, I've said it,
John should be here and other folks should be here to, Caroline can help coordinate, so that we can know exactly what one of these committees does and how it's helpful, and then we can either give it its, give it our blessing or not. All right. Are we good? All right, so we're, and no building permits?
I have a purchase order.
Okay, all right.
To the town, for the town, to Walmart, for the town clerk, for miscellaneous items for the election, mostly food and paper products, for $38.10.
We don't need to sign a purchase order for $38.10, but we have it in front of us. All right, any questions? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Items have already been purchased, I'm sure, so it's kind of a, it's a reimbursement.
It's a reimbursement, okay.
Would you like to tell me?
Yes, I would like to tell us about this. So Coyle Tanner got in touch with us today, Audrey, and for the wetlands permit, so which is the next step in the process, and it's Pine Street, I think, that requires the permitting. It's not either of the others, at least not just yet. So they need the town clerk to sign it, so Caroline will check in with her tomorrow, and they also need applicant information. So they need our signature. So I'm the applicant, I'm listed as the applicant for the town of Rollinsford, and I agree that we can accept electronic data, electronic information, and I will sign as the property owner of the culvert. Thank you so much. Keep these together, and we'll have the town vote to sign them tomorrow.
We need a purchase order for Cliff.
Yes, please put in. Are they really more than $50? Oh, there was another one behind here. So this is the letter I drafted to Mr. Brunel, the follow-up. Would you, I would appreciate if you could both read that.
All right, you know.
Did I email it?
I think so, I read it.
Oh, you read it? Okay. Did you see it?
I was in my phone.
Oh, okay. So, are we good with my signing this?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. That's a nice
one. And just for the public's sake, we're thanking him for his visit. We understand he remains concerned about the damage to his property, and we said that, you know, when the snows go, we're going to measure the length from the middle of the road, see if we can figure that out. I also told them that, you know, that Jeff says that any time he or his crew do something, they report it to the police, and they really are continuing to say that they don't feel anything.
So this was a purchase order for changing the rails, but
we're going to hold off.
Joint Loss about that.
Yeah, speak to Joint Loss and whatever ADA. Yeah, I'm fine. Yeah, you know, whatever ADA thing.
Well, I don't know how if you touch it, then you open up yourself for all of those compliant ADA. Right now we're grandfathered. And so the steps are out,
so that it's not just the railing that's
out. It's not just the railing, it's the steps, it's the height of the steps, it's the width of the steps, it's the landing that's not wide enough.
Well, it would be helpful. It would be helpful at some point.
Tom Clark would be a perfect person to say.
If we can get specs for how to make it better, it would probably, you know, just hearing you would probably need to go on the SIP, on the CIP, right?
Yeah.
So, but we don't know until somebody specs it out, at least a big picture, so we get some ballpark idea of how to enter it for what amount of money.
Right, but Tom would have the parameters of what it's going to take, and it may take steps going almost out to the side. It's because you got to bring the steps gradually down shorter, because they're almost an inch higher than they should be.
And they also have to be wide.
You don't know, yeah.
It's just, you know, we thought it was simple, just cut the rail.
That's okay. We were holding this purchase order till after town meeting on the backhoe, but we have other issues with backhoe going on.
Yep.
So we're gonna hold that.
Let's hold that.
So this was electrical bid for the fire department. We were holding till.
We need to talk to him about that, right? You know, this is a big, you know, it takes up most of his maintenance budget, so.
So we authorized a purchase order up to $1,000 for replacing the shingles at Jeff's shed.
Yeah, we did a PO last week.
Didn't we do a PO?
So maybe that just didn't get attached to the PO. I'm quite sure we did that PO last week.
Yeah, we did.
Because it was one of the
times.
The
Brunei heater.
Pardon?
The Brunei heater.
Yes. No, this is the roofing though.
Oh,
this is the repair. We did the roofing
yes.
too. We did
yes.
two last week.
Yeah.
So that just needs to go with a PO.
Okay. And then our bus passes finally for summer
rec. Oh, okay. So I guess we didn't do
it. It wasn't.
Okay.
Yeah, we were waiting for the budget to pass.
Okay.
So move to accept purchase order 1159 to the Treasurer, Save New Hampshire, the New Hampshire Parks and Rec program is going to be for a bus pass. They call it Summer of Fun for 10 passes to 10 different summer state parks. The amount of $235.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Mrs. Hanson's letter that she read, or you read earlier.
Okay.
And snow removal, they're still waiting for
Oh, that's still one that has too many errors.
Yeah, so we're still waiting
okay.
for an actual thing. And these all we all signed all the results tonight.
Okay.
To the other side. Department of Transportation has given us a list of roads that they are paving. This year and next. For Rollinsford Summersworth, it's going to be from the Dover Rollinsford town line, northerly to the intersection of Indigo Hill Road and Summersworth. Work will include paving through the Rollins Road Oak Street intersection to the beginning of Broadway Street, which makes me very happy.
I think somebody else is happy.
Yes, because we were afraid of
quietly, which is I appreciate. Thank
yes.
you.
Place high strength pavement in line approaching the intersection, construction, concrete chip downs, and fixing the sidewalks. 2018, Rollinsford Summersworth, Rollins, Goodwin Road, Green Street, 3.1 miles, doing a shim from the Dover Rollinsford town line, northerly to the intersection of Indigo Hill Road and Summersworth. So that'll be
that's
the top
2018, code. Right?
Yes.
Not 2017.
Yeah,
so
this will be 2017,
okay.
This
that's
will be 2018.
Okay.
And then Rollinsford Summersworth line from the intersection of Rollins Road in Rollinsford, northerly to the pavement joint at NATO Street in Summersworth. Where is NATO Street in Summersworth?
What?
In Opal. Is NATO way down? Okay. Sorry. And then they also have on the list Rollinsford Silver Street, 1.2 miles, 3/4 paver shim from the intersection of New Hampshire 4 westernly to the intersection of Rollins Road. And Rollinsford Summersworth Road, Main Street, 1.2 miles, 3/4 shim from the intersection of Rollins Road to in Rollinsford northernly to the pavement joint at NATO Street in Summersworth. Place high strength wear coarse pavement at the railroad crossing.
So when is this scheduled?
That is this year, dated January 26, 2017, coming out of fiscal year 2016. So.
Okay. So, well, you know, the state has started to do things, which is good.
So that's great.
Yeah, that's great. Here, I'm going to give this back to you. That's the, you know, Mike was looking at it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because we're we had it the year before last year.
Yeah, we did, that's true. Well, we'll be done doing that soon.
Okay. Department of Transportation, Bureau of Community Assistance. We were gonna sign after town meeting, and it's been so long, I forgot what it was about. The classification of the names, that's what it was. We changed the names.
Oh, we didn't change any names, yeah. Why don't you put a post and say that Caroline and I would work on this?
Because, see, we hadn't changed Cedar and told.
So why were we already knew that, that was last year, right? So why were we waiting?
They hadn't placed it.
I don't know why we were waiting, Josh.
There was a place that you didn't know what it was being changed.
Why don't you just put a note that says Caroline and Suzanne will kind of review and see.
Part of the letter also says that we need to update leadership of the community.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, that could be true.
Oh, that's right, because it has the planning board chairman, conservation chairman. Thank you, Michael.
Sorry, I should have not said at the beginning. So, all right, so, yeah. And it'll come back here if we need to decide.
All right, and Comcast renewal process. Do you want a table for now?
I do, do you?
I do.
Mike? Okay.
And that's it?
We're tabling.
Nothing new.
Excellent. I would like to say something, I forgot earlier, as soon as New Hampshire DOT came up. When I was talking to Jim Gelbert at the beginning of before the meeting started on Saturday, he indicated that there was gonna be, the state was getting an infusion of money, and that some of it was gonna come down to the towns. Do we think that really?
VW money, you mean?
I don't know if it was VW money.
Well, that's what he talked to us about.
That's what he talked to us about, yes.
The governor hasn't even indicated whether or not he's gonna accept the settlement.
Correct, that's what I told him, but no, this was something else that, where the money would come to us. So I had not heard that. So I wondered if anybody, if either of you had heard that, so anyway.
Yes, in the governor's proposed budget, there's a increase in highway grants. Monies, you know, that we get normally.
The block grants come to us?
Yeah.
But. It's not material, is that what you're saying?
Well,
or there's many a slip to the cup on the lip?
Yeah, well, no. The governor did include in his budget, but remember, he's just the first step in the process.
Yeah.
So the House currently has the budget. The House Ways and Means Committee did their revenue estimates last week, the week before last. They're estimating that the state will bring in $55 million less than what the governor estimated. So I wouldn't count on anything. And the good news is the Senate usually has much rosier revenue estimates because they have more actual data to work with, you know, than because the House only had X amount of months to do revenue, base revenue estimates off of the fiscal year, you know what I mean? So by the time they get to, they have three additional months. So theoretically, there could be some additional money, but there's no guarantee.
So, well, the good news is, I mean, we didn't build anything. So what we build is generally what we get. So in December, we know what we're gonna get. And so that's what we use then for the following year.
It'd be great if it comes through, but I mean.
Wonderful. Okay.
One more thing, we just got an email.
Okay.
Great news from C&J. This is from the from Kelly and Dee. C&J will be happy to sponsor the entirety of the shirts for a full $800.
That's wonderful.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you, C&J. That's great news.
She wants more.
Lovely. Yeah. Super duper. All right. If there's no other, if the board has no other business, I'll check in with our public and see if they any community input. Celia?
That is great news from C&J. We are working with our graphic designer right now to figure out if we're going to change our sponsorship levels, because we had not yet gotten our sponsorship letters out, and we had planned on shooting for a goal between $1,200 and $1,300 of corporate sponsorship. So this is more than halfway there.
Okay, good. So that's great news. So I think you should, at some point, we should provide a thank you to our sponsors, right?
That is the plan, and they will begin.
Should come from the board?
They're working on it, thank you.
Okay.
And they are getting, right now, we're in talks with the graphic designer who created the shirts about whether or not they will be the only sponsor on our shirt, because originally we thought we were getting smaller chunks of money and we were going to have fewer that, more sponsors on the back. And then we are also speaking about, like I said, changing our sponsorship levels. And thank you very much for the ideas of where to post things, because in the last week I've had to post two or three different things. I've put out a job ad out here on the community board. I have t-shirt sales and order forms that are going up tonight and maybe, and then we also have camp registrations that are being posted around time too.
Excellent.
Apparently things have changed since we were teenagers too, so. Bulletin boards aren't used anymore, so.
From what I understand, the chair of the historic committee was waiting until after the election to call this next meeting.
I'm sorry, I missed that.
It was,
Historical.
The historical committee was waiting until after the elections to call.
All right. Anything else? Charlie?
Excuse me. You're talking about General Sullivan using less salt. I think you should also look at any wells that we have in Rollinsford and any well in down by the river, less salt because of MS4. I mean, just the runoff.
Yeah.
And in 2015 and 16, we went to all salt. And the reason we went to all salt was we were going to save money because we weren't going to street sweep. And that didn't work out.
Well, no, it did. We pay less for street sweeping.
Oh, you do pay less?
Yes, you do.
But I thought originally it was going to stop street sweeping.
No, we still street sweep.
Okay.
And that's part of the, I mean, that counts as little benefits, yeah, or little positives in our MS4 report.
Just a general thought.
Yeah. It makes sense, you know, they're...
Because you see them in a lot of towns where low salt areas,
you know, we can ask
especially
Mike,
near the river.
When Mike Trank comes to talk to us, we can ask him about that, how, you know, what other areas we might naturally also consider. And you know, he's a water, stormwater person, so he'd be good with just to ask for general information. So thank you. Yeah. But you know, the one of the things that we learned when our water consultant, Scott McGlynn, did the assessment is the outfall is by the Legion, you know, where the park is. It, and Ken Shorey was saying this. I says, yeah, we know that. The silt buildup, I mean, has pushed the riverbank yards into the river. Mm-hmm. And we think a lot of it, not all of it, but a lot of it is coming from Stockdale, down through Partridge Lane, et cetera, et cetera. And that there's a house somewhere on Stockdale. And the, it's eroding part of their side yard. And so what we talked, we're putting check dams, right. So if you recall, some of the things that we have in that stormwater management line this year were check dams,
right,
at that site on Stockdale, so we can try to see where, we can figure out where it's coming from. So, but that, you know, silt is, you know, you've got salt, you've got silt, you've got, you know, none of it's good, but nonetheless, you've got stormwater coming,
it's
gotta, you know,
go someplace.
Yeah, so it's always it appears to be an issue that, you know, what you try to do is mitigate, right, and, you know, make some attempts to make improvements here and just continue to keep working on those kinds of things. So thank you for bringing that up, I appreciate it. All right, not hearing anything else? Shall we adjourn?
Let's go there.
Excellent.